Welcome all my dear students to Sudharma's physics classroom. Today I am here with a very interesting topic from magnetic effect of electric current from class 10. In the previous video we have learned about the basic magnetism concepts, terms related with magnetism, etc. Hope all of you have learned the concepts from that video. And today actually we are entering into the magnetic effect of electric current, because in the previous class we discussed about the basic magnetism properties, and now let's see how electric current passing through a conductor produces magnetism. I'm not sure how many of you heard about the scientist Hans Christian Oersted. Okay, so he is the person who has understood that when electric current passes through a conductor, magnetic field is produced around the conductor. So as you can see in the picture, he was demonstrating some electricity experiment to his students, and he found that a compass needle kept on the table was deflecting. So it made him think that if there is no magnet around that, he was sure that there is no magnet around that, and how the compass needle deflects, right? We understood that the compass needle will deflect only under the effect of a magnetic field. So there after that he started experimenting on that, and he understood that there is a magnetic field, that is why the compass needle started deflecting. So let's learn in detail about the magnetic effect of electric current. So yesterday's experiment is very simple. You have to take a conductor, okay? You have to take a conductor, then you have to connect it to a battery. So this is a cell, this is a 9-volt cell. So you know how to understand the polarity, right? So this is the positive and this is the negative end of the cell. So we are going to connect this. I'm just demonstrating it here. Okay, so I'm going to connect a conductor. This is a copper wire, insulated copper wire. So you can see this, it will be available in everyone's house. So I'm going to connect this wire into the positive and negative end of the cell. So I have a compass needle here. We know that compass needle will deflect in the north-south direction if you simply keep it at some position. So the experiment is as simple as this. You have to take a conductor, connect it to the positive and negative of a cell, keep a compass needle nearby that. I'm not able to show this in this video. I will make a separate video for this experiment. So for the time being, I'm just showing you how to connect it. So you will see a deflection in the compass needle. Okay. So what Oersted has done is he increased the amount of current flowing through the conductor. Then he switched off the circuit, switched on the circuit, and he changed the polarity of the battery. So how do you change the polarity? By changing the polarity of the battery, we mean that changing the positive, initially whichever side was connected to the negative end, now we connect that to the positive end. That means the direction of current is changing. So these were the procedure he has done, and he could see that the deflection of the compass needle was different in each case. Okay, so I'll explain once again. So initially he allowed the current to flow through the conductor, the compass needle was deflecting, he switched off the current, compass needle came back to the zero position. He reversed the direction of current by changing the polarity of the battery, then he could see the deflection of the compass needle was in the opposite direction. He increased the amount of current, the deflection was more. When the deflection is more, we can understand that the magnetic field strength is becoming more. Okay, so those were the conclusions of Oersted's experiment. So here you can see the deflection initially. See, this is how we change the direction of current. So in each case, the direction of compass needle is different. The deflection in the compass needle is different. So this is a change making discovery in science, where Oersted found that the current carrying conductor, any current carrying conductor, can produce magnetic field around it. So after that, many experiments were done, and different shaped current carrying conductors were experimented, and scientists could find out that different shaped current carrying conductors produces different shaped magnetic field. Already we have seen the magnetic field due to a bar magnet. We learned the structure of the magnetic field due to a bar magnet, right? So similarly, we can plot the magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor. So throughout this chapter, we will be learning a straight current carrying conductor, a circular loop, and a solenoid. So three different shaped current carrying conductors and their magnetic field we are going to study in detail. Now, let's study the magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor. Again, let me take a straight current carrying conductor. So what we are going to do is, those who have seen the first video, we know how to plot the magnetic field lines, right? We have two methods. One is using the iron filings and the other one is using the compass needle. So if you use the iron filings, if you connect this straight current, straight conductor along the positive and negative end of the battery, the iron filings will align in this particular shape. You can see this in the second picture. Okay, you can see that it is circular in shape. In the first diagram, you can see how we have to perform the experiment. So we will be inserting a thick cardboard sheet. This conductor will be inserting to a cardboard sheet. Then on that, we will be after the connections are done, we will move the compass needle and follow the direction of the north pole of the compass needle and do the experiment. You will see that there will be circular magnetic field. Okay, so the current due to a straight current, the magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor are circular in nature. They are concentric circles, and the center will be at the conductor itself. Another property is when you come close to the conductor, the magnetic field will be more. You can see the magnetic field lines are very close to each other, and when you move away from the conductor, the magnetic field lines will be separated away. Okay, so field due to straight conductors are concentric circles. Nearby the conductor, the strength is more. If you move away from the conductor, then the strength will be less. It's very similar to our bar magnet, right? When you move away from the bar magnet, magnetic field strength is less. Okay, so in this diagram, you can see there is an arrow shown in this diagram, right? See there, observe the arrow. So that indicates the direction of magnetic field. Okay, so how do you find out the direction of magnetic field due to a straight conductor? We have a right hand thumb rule. Okay, right hand thumb rule to find out the direction of magnetic field. So right hand thumb rule states that if you keep the right hand thumb in the direction of current and wrap around the conductor with the other fingers, you will see the direction in which the other fingers wrapping around the conductor will give you the direction of magnetic field. So with a simple demonstration, I can show you how to understand the answer for this. So first of all, we look at the diagram given in the question and we decide in which direction the current is flowing. Always current will flow from positive to negative end of the battery. So once you decide the direction of current, for example, if the current is in the upward direction, we are going to take a pen. Okay, the nib of the pen, the tip of the pen, we take as the direction of current. Keep the thumb in the direction of current. You may be seeing my left hand because the camera mirror image, lateral inversion will take place. Lateral inversion we'll discuss in light chapter. Okay, that is an optical phenomenon. Okay, so just excuse me if you are seeing my hand as left. It is right hand. You have to use your right hand. Okay, so keep your right hand thumb in the direction of current. Wrap around the conductor. The direction in which the fingers are wrapping around the conductor will give you the direction of magnetic field. So when the thumb is upward, when the current is upward, we will get an anti-clockwise magnetic field. When the current is downward, keep the thumb in the downward direction, right hand thumb in the downward direction, wrap around the conductor, you will get a clockwise magnetic field. Now, if the current is towards your left, keep your right hand thumb like this. You see that the fingers are trying to come into the plane. Okay, this is the word you have to use. It is into the plane. Okay, so whenever you do an experiment, if you see your fingers are just trying to go into something, right? This is how it goes into something. So it is into the plane. You see these options in the answers, no need to worry, into the plane. If the current is towards your right side, my fingers wrapping around the conductors are trying to come out of the plane. Okay, it's coming out of the plane. So this is the simplest trick where we can use the right hand thumb rule to find the direction of magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor. We have three hand rules to learn in this chapter. So learn thoroughly. This is to find out the direction of magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor. Another one is Maxwell's corkscrew rule. It is the same thing. We have to insert the screw into the direction of current. So if the current is in the downward direction, we are just going to insert the screw this way, right? We are getting a clockwise current. We are just screwing it clockwise. If it is the other way, we have to screw it. So my fingers are coming in the anti-clockwise direction. This is what we have seen in the other case also. Okay, so hope you understood how to apply right hand thumb rule. Okay, now I have the answer for the last class homework question. There is a surprise for you. There is one student who answered me very quickly. As soon as she saw the video, she answered me in the chat box and in the mail. She sent me the diagram in the mail. And there are many students who has done that. I'm very happy with that. And I'm announcing the name of the child who has sent me that first. Okay, so this take it as a challenge and try to send me the answer as soon as possible. Okay, so this is our homework question. And Medha from Trivandrum is the child who has sent me the answer as the in the first attempt. Okay, so she is going to be the winner of last class homework question. And congratulations for those who have sent me the answers. I'm saying this because she sent me first. Okay, and don't worry, who missed the chance, you have a chance in today's class also. There is a challenge question for today. Okay, so let's answer this question first, then go to today's challenge question. So the question was, we have to find out the direction of north. We have to decide which is north and south. Okay, so the clue was, this is the direction given. This is the only direction given in the question. So we know that magnetic field lines move away from a north pole. So here you can see something moving away. We can see this as the north pole. Okay, so X is north pole and Y is the south pole. Now we know the property of magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines emerge from the north and reaches to the south. Outside the magnet, it will be from north to south, right? So this is how the magnetic field has to come. Now on the other side, again it is from north to south, so this is the direction of magnetic field at the position D also. Okay, now here comes your challenge question for this session. Okay, so a thick wire hanging from a wooden table, an anti-clockwise magnetic field to be produced around the wire by passing current through this wire by using a battery. Which terminal of the battery should be connected to the top end of the wire and bottom end of the wire? There are two questions. Give reason for your choice. You have the choice. You have the choice for this. So whichever answer you choose, you have to give reason for that. And I expect the diagram also. And again, I'm giving you the mail ID. You can send your answers to sudha.aju2005@gmail.com. I'm waiting for your answers. And the winner, the first person who sent me the answer, his or her name will be given in the next video. And next video, again, I promise you, I'll be coming with a challenging question. So those who understood the right hand thumb rule will be able to solve this question. Try to visualize. Okay, try to visualize in your real life. Then try to answer this question. Okay, so hope all of you understood the yesterday experiment and the right hand thumb rule. Okay, so in the coming video, I will be there with magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop and solenoid. Much more interesting stuffs are waiting for you. So stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon for more videos. I will be coming very soon with straight current carrying conductor and solenoid. Thank you for watching and bye for today. Okay, bye.